Sometimes it's hard to recognize speech.
Excuse me?
I said it's hard to recognize speech.
I thought you said it's hard to recognize speech.
Well, that's even harder. I'm Dr. Elia Tripp.
And I'm Dr. Ben Munson, and we're researchers in the Speech Language Hearing Sciences Department at the University of Minnesota. We are studying how watching someone's face while they talk can affect your understanding of their speech.
So wait, does watching someone's face while they talk actually affect whether you can understand the words coming out of their mouth?
That's a good question, and there's a lot of evidence that it does. When you're able to see someone's face, then you can potentially get extra clues about what they are saying. You can see their facial expression and the shapes they're making with their mouth at the same time as you can hear their speech.
But are those clues actually helpful? When we test people in the lab to explore how they interpret speech, we call this a speech perception task. So the question is, do people do a better job with audiovisual speech perception tasks, where they can both see and hear the talker? Or do they do better in audio-only tasks, where they're only listening? Is it actually possible that seeing someone's face can make the speech perception task easier?
Absolutely. There's a lot of evidence that seeing someone helps us understand what they are saying, especially if the listening task is difficult, like listening in background noise. However, there's also evidence that the audiovisual benefit varies and might depend on what the listener believes about the person who is talking. Molly Babel and Jamie Russell did a study on this topic in 2015.
Hi, I'm Dr. Molly Babel, a faculty member in linguistics at the University of British Columbia. Jamie Russell and I did a study a couple years ago where we recorded people from a suburb of Vancouver that's known for having a large East Asian population. All of these people that we recorded were born in Canada and so spoke standard Canadian English. None of them had foreign accents. We also took pictures of these people. Half of the individuals that we recruited were ethnically Chinese and half of the individuals were self-identified as white. We did a speech perception task with these sentences that we recorded, and we played them in a little bit of noise to make the task a little bit harder. In half of the trials, we just played the sentences with no visual images. In that condition, listeners were equally accurate at being able to identify the words that the ethnically Chinese and what the white people had said. In another condition, the sentences were played along with the pictures of the people who had produced those sentences. In that condition, listeners were less accurate in reporting what the Chinese voices had said as opposed to what the white voices had said. And one possibility in these results are that seeing an ethnically Chinese face prompts listeners to expect people to speak with a Chinese accent, and that wasn't the case with these speakers.
So it sounds like people's race and ethnicity might be important to understanding audiovisual speech perception.
Yes, potentially so. The problem is that we don't have very many studies on audiovisual speech perception across race and ethnicity. We just don't know much about how audiovisual speech perception works with racially and ethnically diverse talkers. And that's why we're doing a study on this topic. In this first part of the study, we're using video conferencing to make video recordings of people from different races and ethnicities speaking so that we can use those recordings in future speech perception studies.
You could be a part of this research if you meet these three qualifications. First, you must have learned English from birth in North America, the US or Canada, from at least one primary caregiver who spoke it to you consistently.
Like a parent or a grandparent.
Second, you must have an internet connection and a device like a smartphone, tablet, or computer that can run the Zoom video conferencing software. Your device must have a video camera and a microphone. And third, you need a place to make recordings, like a private room where you can shut the door and be alone.
We will compensate participants $25 per hour of participation using either Amazon or Google Pay. And we anticipate that people who qualify for this study will participate in a single two-hour session. If something comes up where you have to break your participation across two sessions, we can accommodate that. You can participate from wherever you have a private space, so this work can take place even if there are restrictions on whether people can leave their homes.
We're very excited to do this study on this important topic, and we hope that you can be a part of it. Please contact avspeech@umn.edu to request more information.
We look forward to meeting you.